Join me as I've just left the Port Patrick car park on the Rins of Galloway, Scotland. I'm about to head south down the coast to the 16th century clifftop ruin of Dunskey Castle. After exploring the remains of Dunskey Castle, I will venture further south down the coast to get fabulous views of the expansive Morrock Bay. From there, I will walk further down the coast as far as Nockenham Lodge before circling back towards Port Patrick. Along the way, I get many fabulous views, wonderful sounds of nature, and even meet a new friend. The coastal path starts by making a climb, but looking back offers great views over Port Patrick. Here the coastal path crosses a ravine via the wooden Taylor's Peak Bridge. As I was walking along the coastal path, I noticed to my left what looked like an old railway cutting. Indeed, Port Patrick used to have a railway and a railway station. Later in the video, I will give more information on the old railway when I happen upon some more relics of the Port Patrick old railway line. We soon get the remains of Dunskey Castle coming into view, as it's only a half a mile walk from Port Patrick car park. On the site of Dunskey Castle, there used to be a medieval fort which was destroyed in 1489, and the present structure was built by the Adairs of Kinhilt. The Adairs of Kinhilt also owned the Castle of St John in Stranraer, some 6 miles away. Watch out for an up and coming video where I explore the Castle of St John and Stranraer. The castle had a rock-cut ditch to protect the landward side and was extended up until the 17th century, but by 1684 it lay in ruin. The castle is reputed to be haunted by the ghost of a nursemaid who dropped a baby from one of the windows onto the beach far below. I had no evidence of the nursemaid, but on this day a puppy dog had fallen off the cliff of the castle towards the beach far below. The castle is also said to be haunted by a spectral piper and jester who was imprisoned but found a way into the caves below the old stronghold. He was never seen again, but the sounds of his pipes are sometimes reputedly heard. We're now going to head down the coast towards Morroc Bay whilst looking upon views of Dunsky Castle. Here we get our first fabulous views of Muroc Bay. Muroc Bay is a private bay and beach where sits two cottages that can be hired for the week. Now I'm dropping down through this wooded area towards the Nottingham Lodge Hotel. This is the Nottingham Lodge Hotel, along with its fabulously well-tended gardens. At this point, I appear to catch the eye of somebody.
All right, pal.
I am now heading back towards Port Patrick down this single track road. I only see one car in 40 minutes or so I'm walking down it. Ahead of us, we see another relic of the Port Patrick Old Railway Line, a viaduct. To me, it still looked in use, such was its condition. A railway station was first established in Port Patrick in 1862. However, Port Patrick was one of the earlier closures of British Railways management and ceased operation on the 6th of February 1950. Here I am near the Port Patrick car park where I started, having completed this circular walk. The walk was 6.5 miles in total and took 3 hours including the exploring. In another video I explored Port Patrick and the old Port Patrick Parish Church. I will put the link up now if you're interested in watching.